I can name a couple ways, maybe this shit might go. You just might forget that this was what you're getting hyped for. Minute light into the day, so I'm in that guy who needs someone who's sweet and up, won't shoot to make that high low.
Bow, it's your girl. Do I look crazy? Nah, I look okay. It's your girl. We back with another video, and let me tell y'all. You know, at first I'm gonna do the intro because I'm very excited right now. Welcome to anybody who is new to my channel. If you are a recurring subscriber, welcome back. I love you. Thank you guys for tuning in for another one of my crazy videos, because today I gotta talk. This video is gonna be me getting ready to go, so you're gonna be watching me get ready. But I really gotta get something off my chest. I really gotta say something. We're gonna get into it. So we're gonna be using the Rare Beauty Weightless Foundation again. I actually just recorded the review of me using this, and I already know that it's amazing, so I am very excited to use this again. We're gonna get into why do men feel like they can come in and out of your life. Not taking into account that I may be a different person and I'm not the same person that you knew before, right? You are coming into my life to try to pick up where you left off at. And when I tell you that you can't do that, you can't just come back into my life. And this is not one person. I know that somebody's gonna see this video and think that it's a sub. This is not a sub to any one person. It is weird when I tell you that the majority of the men that I've talked to in my life for the past 3 years, if there were 10 of them, 9 of them have come back into my life and apologized for what they've done to me, and they wanna get back together. Baby boy, whoa. Didn't I just tell y'all? I literally just told y'all. I gotta hit him with the who's this. Wow. I be getting text messages from people who do me dirty, who wanna come back into my life and act like nothing happened. I must be a real good person. I must be a real good person for people to feel so comfortable coming back into my life after the things that they've done and just act like nothing happened. Pick up where you left off type of business. Am I that approachable? I'm confused. I don't know if that's a good thing or not. Like, I don't know. Will never get old. The blend, girl, the blend. Selena Gomez, for you to put my entire face in a bottle, I respect you so much, but I really want to know where you got my skin sample from. I really want to try the Fenty one too. There's a Fenty in 390, I think that's my color. If Fenty and 390 is the same color as Rare Beauty and 420N, then I will be a happy, happy girl. So happy. Honestly, Pro Concealer is probably the best, cheapest concealer that you can get from your local beauty supply store. My ideal color is Fawn. Even in the summer, even in the winter, it stays the same. Now, this is really cool, beating your face, because you got to do this whole process. And now you see me living my life, you commenting, you messaging me, hitting me up, all the stupid shit. Like, what you want, boy? What you want? Y'all see how this Rare Beauty look on my skin, though? But I'm like, what you want, boy? How can I help you? I hate when I wear black and I do this. But I'm like, really though, why are you hitting me up? You think you could just pop back into my life? Hey, how's it going? You know that when we ended it cordially, we ended it cordially, but to not speak again. We didn't end it cordially to be friends still. Like, I don't understand why people think that they could do whatever it is that they want to do, put you in weird ass positions. Like, you literally was going to tell me to leave so shorty could be in the house and then hit me up months later like, hey, how's it going? Like, boy, I don't care what the problem was. I don't care who you stuck up on. Not me, not I. Like, you don't get second chances with me. No, I guess something you guys should know about me and the Rose Guard is that my channel was founded off of, like, sadly to say, but it's my truth. It was founded off of heartbreak. Like, my ex did something that I didn't take too kindly, and I always had the YouTube channel, but I had it underneath a different name. So I had to change the name because he was being a douchebag about it. So I had to, because it was our last names combined. But I had to change that, and the Rose Guard was just birthed from that. But my heart has never, I've never treated my heart the right way. Like, I've always been like freezing my heart to like not feel the emotional pain that comes from each heartbreak. Like, whenever I feel like somebody's doing something and they, you know, they did me dirty, I got people who had kids on me. I got people who, how you gonna try to cheat on me? We're not even together. Bruh. See, another one. I got people who lied about having girlfriends, knowing that they had girlfriends, had their girlfriends calling me, asking me. I've noticed that he talks to you nicer than he talks to me, and I've known him for X amount of years, and I'm like, I've known him just the same amount of time. I don't know why he treats me different than he treats you. You're gonna have to talk to him about that. I didn't even know that you existed as his girlfriend. I'm glad I dodged that bullet, you know, but I've constantly had to freeze my heart, which is so annoying, because it's like, I want to love, I want to trust, I don't want to have trust issues, I don't want to blame one guy for the next man's, you know, stupidity, but you know what happens, but you get mad when I become a savage. I don't want to be a savage, I want to be nice, I want to be a girl, I want to be pretty, I want to be loved, I want to go on dates and picnics and cute stuff. I decided to go through whatever it was that I was gonna go through with dignity, okay? You're not gonna make me not wanna love. You're not gonna make me, you know, put what you did onto the next man that didn't do anything wrong. So, I decided to kill people with kindness. I don't gotta be aggressive. I don't gotta be hateful. I don't have to do anything out of pocket. I'll still look at you, blow a kiss, because you're gonna see what you missed. You know? And honestly, I feel like that's the best thing. The best thing that you could possibly do to show people that you're over them and that you don't care is to literally work on yourself and do good. People are looking on my Instagram like, oh, I see you doing the thing, you blowing up this, that, and the other. I'm like, boy, I'm just doing whatever I want to do. Like, and nobody's going to tell me not to. So what you're seeing is me happy. Build your, whatever your business is, build your platform, build your company, do you. And they're all gonna come back. They're all gonna flock. You don't gotta be malicious. You don't gotta do none of that. Because they're gonna come, because they watch you anyway. They freaking watch you anyway, because it's insane. Literally insane how every guy that I spoke to in the past 3 years came back, oh, how you doing? Oh, what's going on? And not that I mind friendship, but like, you gotta come back in and acknowledge what you did before so we can move on and have a good relationship platonically. Don't pop back in, hey, like the dude today, hey, how you doing? I'm fine, sir. What do you want? I know you for being toxic. And because I'm in a good place right now, what do you want? I'm about to apply some lashes off camera and I'll be back. Bow. I did it. I can't tell y'all where these lashes are from. I think they're from Kiss. Yeah. I think these lashes are from Kiss. Definitely. Most likely. Yes. But I'll do a eyelash tutorial if you guys need. I definitely don't know how I was doing glam looks without lashes before. I look like a whole naked mole rat. For real. Like, and y'all ain't even gotta be like, no, I look like a naked mole rat. It's cool. I looked at myself and said it, so I know other people were saying it too. I think the thing that's most like shocking for me, and like in the most humblest way I could probably say this, is that I never knew I was the shit until I realized I was the shit. And not because I got the biggest boobs or I got butt implants or anything like that, but because I'm a great person. Like, I'm really there for people. And people know that, and I feel like that's exactly why they come back and they're all like, oh, hey, this, that, and the other, because I'll keep it cool with you, you know, because giving somebody else that power, you don't get no power over me. You don't get no power over me. For me to be thinking about you, for me to be like, oh, why did he do this, that, and the other? No. I see your movements. Carry on. Definitely carry on. I'm just gonna take this NK makeup, the regular one from Beauty Splash though, and chocolate. No, light brown. But yes, this is the finishing look. Just closing remarks. I know sometimes guys are doing you wrong, right? And this goes for the guys, y'all can flip it that way too, vice versa. I know the other person that you're trying to give your attention to, he or she may be doing you wrong. But handle that lightly. Don't be petty. Don't try to be a savage. The best way to be a savage is by working on your money, working on your business, working on your health, your life, working on just yourself. Never let them think, oh yeah, I stopped talking to her, she down. Well, him and he down. Boy. I think they're starting to understand the worst thing you could do in the case with me is underestimate me. You really shouldn't do that. Not like in the most humblest way possible. I didn't always have this confidence. But now that I do have this confidence, anybody that did me dirty and y'all came back, I'm through with my dramatics. Thank you guys for listening to me rant. I hope you guys like this finishing look. I'm really digging this kind of seductive red look I got going on. Let me know if y'all like it. Comment, subscribe, share, you know, check out my website for more like makeup, art, photography, poetry, and things like that. I will be filming a poetry. I'm going to do a voiceover for a painting that I'm about to do for my goddaughter. Tune in for that, and I hope you guys like it. Yeah, thank you guys for watching, and remember, don't let them decide who you want to be. Show them who you are. Okay, and that's all, period. Pow. Y'all know I love my booty blenders. I'm just gonna keep saying booty blender because that's what I'm used to, so I'm just gonna keep saying booty blender. Are you still with him, or what's going on? You know, because he doesn't talk to me the way he talks to you. I've never heard him say such things. can I help you? Not that I want to help you. And last but not least, my finishing touches are just little like beauty marks wherever I got a pimple at. You cannot survive here. You will not live here. As Jesse J would say, who's laughing now? I am laughing now. I am laughing now. 17-year-old Miley. 7-year-old Miley. Ooh. 14. Ooh, I remember 14. They was breaking my heart left and right. But now, you know what? We here, we active. And they all in my DMs right now. And you know what I'm saying? Excuse me, sir? Wrong number.